See how hot you are?
Yeah.
You
know. You were being
No problem. It's going to be okay.
Thank you, Doug.
Yes.
I care about this game. I love everything about it. And maybe I worked it up too much in my own head. This situation I'm in isn't even about the environment. This is all about my own head. I'm a thinker. I get stuck in my own head. I know that I brought this upon myself. It's that feeling of you can't even make the choice of what you need to do for yourself to make the right decision of, like, I need to do this, this, and this to feel better, to make myself feel better.
Aubry wasn't, like, ill dehydrated. She hadn't even gotten to the point of, like, chapped lips. So for her, it was really more of an anxiety attack. She was just freaking out about freaking out.
You're
gonna be okay.
And
once you're hydrated,
we will.
Once we have a fire, you're gonna feel awesome again.
You're just gonna cool off.
I wish you guys got to meet me.
Whatever impression she's giving off on day two, I do think there's a significant risk that she cracks again next time something doesn't go well. Maybe we should get rid of him.
I mean, are you serious? You come back with that or what? I just went along with what we're gonna do, and now all of a sudden you're changing. You can't do that. Is this part of your, like, neuroses and all, where you get all worried about this kind of stuff? But what? Seriously.
I don't know what the hell is gonna happen. And it puts me in a bad situation. No matter what I do, it's gonna blow back and bite me in the ass.
Aubry was still so uncertain about the vote that she changed hers at the last second.
Sixth person voted out. Peter.
I went up there, wrote Julia, crossed it out, and wrote Peter, and I ended up putting a target on my back and on Joe.
If I have to go to another tribal, I am absolutely going to write down Aubry, Joe. Aubry, Joe. I don't just cross them out until I decide which one I want to go first.
I know it took everything within Neil not to get upset, because he wants to play so badly, and he just told us how lucky we were to be here. And he's right. I didn't think I'd be crying this much on Survivor, but there have been ups and downs, and right when I thought that we were gonna get some traction under us, my biggest ally's out of the game. When people say in Survivor that one bad decision is a snowball effect, damn, I feel the avalanche right now. It's like I can't get my head above water. First, Neil was out of the game, then I picked the team, and apparently it was a big mess up. Sucks. I wanted so much more than this, and I'm not giving up. I just feel like I keep making bad decision after bad decision.
If it came down to it, would you vote with me or would you vote with them?
I just feel mentally exhausted today. This is a rough one.
It's like Sophie's choice.
I have no clue who I'm voting for tonight. It's gonna be a game time decision.
Tony, that's five, that's enough. Need to bring me your torch. Malcolm. JT.
Damn.
I'm constantly on the bottom, and I feel like I've been trying really hard to build relationships with those people, but then it all blows up in my face.
Here we go.
Pretty standard day for me in Survivor, up and down. Really feel great at the immunity challenge, winning. Never happened before. And I had a good relationship with Andrea, so naturally she's gonna get killed off too. My pattern in Survivor seems to be really high highs and really low lows.
I love you, you know that.
I love you too.
This game is hard. I cried before I came. I was like,
me too. Yeah. Why are you doing
this? Like,
when you get to a certain point on Survivor, your mind goes to places you don't think it's gonna go. And when you get home, it's really, really hard to explain what you've been through. After I played, when I went home, people say, why are you different? And I couldn't say why.
Oh, are you crying now? Stop.
God, and I don't ever cry.
I'm kind of crying too.
It's so hard. If you've never done it, I didn't know how hard it was on Monica to get this far.
Yeah.
She got home. I get it. And
feel like an elderly person who came out one last time to have a hurrah at playing their favorite sport. It's tough. Like, this happened with Suri and Sierra. We're just tired. I'm exhausted this time. I feel way more tired than I did on day 39 of Survivor Korong.
I have to say, Jeff, this is much harder than the first time I played. It's not just physical, it's mental, it's morale. I mean, I think we've all kind of sat around and gotten emotional at times, and that affects everything.
One of the most powerful moments on Survivor.
And I was crying watching Suri.
Aubry, you're up. Who's here?
I think it's my sister, Carrie.
Your sister, Carrie. Come on out, Carrie.
This is everyone.
Hi, everyone.
I wanted a family visit, and it never came. And I just started crying because I couldn't wait to see my sister.
Congratulations, you have found a hidden immunity idol.
I find the idol and I break down in tears. I never thought I'd find one. And I've been through so much in Survivor, and this is something that I haven't gotten yet.
I'm so proud of myself.
It's worth the effort to work through the struggle. And I love this game so much, and I'm gonna make it work for me. I'm used to playing from behind, and I don't know how to play when I have cards in my hand. When I got the royal flush, I don't know what the hell to do. Like, I have alliances starting, I feel good with Vic, but I almost don't know what to do when something somewhat positive happens in this game. Like, I have choices to make with big things, and I feel like that means I'm gonna be voted out tonight. But maybe that's not the mentality to have. Every time I try to do something in Survivor, something goes wrong. Like, maybe I have to have a little faith that maybe just a little bitty thing can go right.
Aubrey's absolutely right. There were definitely conversations that I was in. I'm just hoping that everyone didn't get into their own heads.
I mean, I can sometimes be an overthinker, but sometimes things are more simple than they seem.
Fifth person voted out of Survivor. Aubry, that's three, that's enough.
You guys are unbelievable players.
I never give up. For me, as soon as it hits the rock bottom, that's my favorite part, because I know it can only go up. I thrive at pulling myself up from the bottom.
Survivor's just given me so much in my life, and I owe so much to this game, and I'm grateful. But I got played, and I got played hard, and I'm proud to stand with these guys, and I'm just grateful to you, Jeff, and everyone here, because otherwise I don't think I would have grown up without Survivor.
Little wine.
Did you say wine?
Coleslaw is really great.
Coleslaw.
I like this coleslaw.
Coleslaw?
Start with the chocolate.
Calamari.
An egg.
Go yourself.